Welcome at the last week of the MOOC Introduction to Water and Climate. This week, I will interview 5 professors about their challenges in their field of research. During the first week, you have learned what a global water cycle is and how you can calculate its water fluxes and storages. All this information is very useful for the challenges for now and in the future. I have asked Professor Savanaye about his challenges in the field of hydrology. And welcome Professor Savanaye in studio. You talked about all the basic processes in hydrology, about the hydrological cycle, the water balance, precipitation, evaporation, and about runoff processes. Does that now mean that we have a full grasp of hydrology?
The fundamental components of the hydrological cycle we have discussed, of which the water balance is of course the most binding element. It is in fact conservation of mass. But in describing the different components of the water balance, the different processes, we have only scratched the surface.
Is it so much more complicated then? And can you present more details about how this process is in the following module, for instance?
Yes, it is very complicated. But I would very much like to develop separate MOOCs which go much deeper into these different processes, particularly the runoff generating processes, of which there are several, each with very different characteristics and temporal and spatial scales. It very much depends on the climate and the landscape which runoff processes are dominant. And another complicating factor is that several runoff mechanisms can happen at the same time. Huh? And then it's difficult to say which is which.
I can imagine this, it is complicated, but I'm sure that the hydrologists understand these processes very well and that you can teach the students about it.
Well, yes. But there is still a lot that we don't know. The scientific community of hydrologists is still doing fundamental research to better understand these processes and subsequently to translate these into reliable models that we can use for prediction.
What would you say is the major challenge for hydrology?
Well, for me, it is the linkage between landscape, climate, and hydrology. The landscape, the hydrology, and the climate co-evolved over time. And each of them contains information about the other. You cannot understand the climate without looking at the landscape and the hydrology. And you cannot understand the hydrology without considering the climate and the landscape. And you can only understand the landscape if you consider how the climate and the hydrology function together and how they have functioned together over the ages that shaped these landscapes. So from studying these three elements in conjunction, there is a lot of understanding that we can obtain about the fundamental processes of runoff generation, but also of groundwater recharge, of landscape climate interaction. This knowledge would also help us to predict hydrological behavior in other areas where information is lacking or where hydrological measurements are not available. We call this prediction in ungauged basins. Mm. If we would know better how to do that, then we could also better understand the rules of upscaling or downscaling, or to apply this knowledge in catchments where we have no data at all. There is still a world to discover in hydrology.
Here at Delft University, researchers from our water management department are doing great work in addressing these challenges so that we can find solutions for a better future step by step. Listen, for example, to Miriam Koenders, who investigates the role of evaporation in more detail.
60 to 80% of the rainfall evaporates, which makes it really important for flood and drought forecasting. However, knowledge on evaporation is really limited due to the high cost for measuring and the technical difficulties. Two challenges we can identify in evaporation. First of all, to quantify evaporation, and secondly, to partition evaporation into the different components like transpiration, soil evaporation, and interception evaporation. To tackle these two challenges, we're going to measure evaporation. First with DTS, where we can measure with fiber optic cable temperature and relative humidity profiles. If we apply the DTS technique in the forest, we can also say something about the partitioning of the evaporation. Secondly, to cross-validate our results, we're also going to apply isotopes. By sampling the air and the soil moisture, we also can get knowledge about the evaporation of the different components. In the end, this results into a better understanding of evaporation at different temporal and spatial scales, which will improve our hydrological modeling.
Interesting research, isn't it? Well, this is the first video in week 6. Next video will be about the challenges in the field of the water systems.